Are you sick and tired of gambling your hard-earned money on Madden packs? Well, look no further than my sponsor, MMOEXP, for the cheapest and the most reliable MUG coins on the market. And don't forget to use code FERDY at checkout for 5% off. The link for their website will be right at the top of the description. Are you looking to take your Madden game to the next level? Look no further than Civil.gg for the best ebooks on the market. Choose one of two membership options, and don't forget to use code FERDY at checkout for 25% off. What's going on, guys? Today we have the very, 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 very highly requested quarterback tier list. This video, is it overdue? Maybe a little bit, but I think it's a perfect time to update it right before, you know, Zero Chill goes to Madden stuff. So probably do a tier list, you know, today, and then probably do another quarterback tier list around the new year, maybe after Christmas, somewhere around that time after all this crazy content comes out for December. But yeah, before we hop into it, about half you guys who watch the videos are actually not subscribed. So if you right now is not subscribed with Noties on, make sure you go ahead and do that. We are almost at 30,000 subscribers and we're about less than 700 away. So we're growing super quick right now. So shout out to you guys for, you know, supporting the channel, doing that good stuff. But yeah, let's just hop into it. So here's the tier list. And it's looking pretty good so far. We got Dan Marino still at S tier. We got Josh Allen. Some new names are Big Ben. Jake Plummer's down here at B tier. We got Dak Prescott down here. Mike White's down here. I think he's also a new name. So I think maybe Jameis as well. And then where's Baker? Baker's somewhere here too. There's Baker. So a couple new names on the list so far today. But the first name we're looking at is going to be Marcus Mariota. Okay, so before we even really get started, I do want to say the biggest thing with a quarterback is who you're comfortable with. And also, there are a bunch of different quarterbacks. Like, there's Hiram Master right now. We have Gunslinger. We have the Field Generals who, you know, have the set feet and the Fearless combo. There's also the Scramblers that get, you know, like Mariota that get, you know, some really good, you know, escape artist abilities. Mariota is really nice because he gets, like, some discounted abilities. So that's why I like Mariota a whole lot. But yeah, there's a whole bunch of different quarterbacks in the game right now. And the biggest thing is just what you're comfortable with. So you might value maybe Mike Vick higher. Also, I feel like there are quarterbacks that have higher skill. You need more skill to use. Like Mike Vick, in a good player's hands, Mike Vick's that guy. Like Mike Vick is that guy. So same with like Lamar Jackson and also, you know, Randall Cunningham as well. Like a lot of these running quarterbacks, in the right player's hands, they are dangerous. They can be very dangerous. But a lot of the times you see Mike Vick, he's looking very mid because not everyone has that skill level to use a guy like Mike Vick. But let's just get started here with Marcus Mariota. Okay, so Marcus Mariota, 90 speed, 90 acceleration, and the stats on this card are not the greatest as far as his accuracy goes with 87, 87, 86. He does have the Aaron Rodgers Gunslinger 1 release, so a pretty solid release. A good ball carrier, but the reason, like I said, why I love Mariota is because of these discounted abilities and also the fact that he does get every single team chem. So a lot of flexibility here, maybe not ability wise, but team chem wise, like he fits on any theme team. And it's just a really nice quarterback to have, even if you're not going to use Marcus. I mean, what is his price right now? Yeah, 49, 50K right now. Even if you're not going to use Marcus as your number one quarterback, I think having him as your backup, even on, you know, a theme team could be interesting because you're still getting the speed boost. It's every single team chem. You're getting an extra team chem too. And if you want to, say you have like a pocket passer quarterback, and if you want to run like a read option or maybe a shovel option, whatever you want to run, you can put in Marcus and maybe get the job done that way. But yeah, where's Marcus going on the tier list today? I'm gonna put Marcus Mariota right in front of Mike Vick, and I know that one's gonna get a bunch of hate, but I like Marcus's release. He's a righty. Discounted abilities. I mean, that one could be debated. I definitely see a couple comments down below about it already. But yeah, I'm gonna throw Mariota in front of Mike Vick for sure. So next up, we have Hot Route Master Kirk Cousins, and this is a really nice card. I feel like he's not too flashy, but does get hot route, doesn't have like a crazy release, doesn't have crazy accuracy stats, but just a really solid card, mainly because of that hot route. That's the main reason why you're going to see Kirk. If you don't need Hot Route Master, then guys like, you know, Josh Allen, Jim Kelly, all the guys that are going to be above him are obviously better. But if you want Hot Route and you're kind of working on a budget, like Kirk right now is going for like 80K, I think. So pretty good price right there for Kirk. So, I mean, Hot Route Master, good accuracy stats, decent release. Just kind of a really solid card. Doesn't do anything too crazy, but does get Hot Route and can rely if you need him to. 6'3", good height. So Kirk Cousins, definitely a card I am a fan of. I used him for a little bit there. But yeah, I'm going to throw Kirk Cousins in front of Big Ben here at A tier. I do think Kirk Cousins is really that good. A really, really nice card. Okay, so I just realized I made a mistake. I should have left Tom Brady on the tier list. I should have left Brady on the tier list, and I was supposed to go over Big Ben. So I'm just going to swap these two real quick. So you already know where Big Ben's going to go, but I'm just going to swap it real quick. So yeah, that's where Brady's going though. Brady's very outdated right now, all that good stuff. So Brady's going to go there. And let's go over her Big Ben stats. I just realized I made a mistake right there. It's okay though, it's not a big deal. Okay, so Big Ben, where is he going? He's a hot route master quarterback who is 6'5 with a good release. A lot of people didn't try this card out. I mean, I'm talking like 90% of the community probably didn't try this card out because he was a limited time card. He's very expensive. He still is kind of expensive. So Big Ben, not a very popular card, but just know that he does play well. If you want to see gameplay on him, I did do a gameplay on this card. I got my words mixed up right there, but good throw power, good short, good mid, decent defense at the threshold, good break sack, good throw under pressure, and throw under pressure, very important stat that, you know, Brady has 88 throw under pressure, and on a card that is literally a cone out there, you're going to want to have good throw under pressure because you cannot escape that pressure. So the very important stat for these pocket passing quarterbacks. So where's Big Ben going? We're going to throw him right in front of Marcus Mariota. Surprise, surprise. And real quick, I do want to say, if you do not need Hot Route Master and you're watching this video right now, guys like Big Ben, you know, maybe even Kirk or Tom Brady, they're really not that great stat-wise. And really, I mean, they do play solid, but they're not anything special. Like those three guys, Kirk, Ben, Tom, and even Herbert as well, I throw in there. If they didn't have Hot Route Master, they'd probably be like down in this conversation. Honestly, I would probably take Mac Jones, Zach Wilson, Joe Burrow, and Carson Wentz over those guys if I didn't need Hot Route Master. But because they get that ability, and it's a very valued ability right now, we're kind of in a weird spot in the quarterback landscape where some guys have Hot Route, some guys have Gunslinger, some guys, you know, we're kind of in a weird spot. It'd be much easier if everyone just kind of got Hot Route and Gunslinger. It'd be much easier for me. But yeah, I am going to say if you don't need Hot Route, a lot of these B tier guys are better. They really are. It, like how they play in games. So keep that in mind. And also, I do like some of their abilities a little bit more too, on the fact that they're able to get, you know, fearless. I love that ability. So yeah, I don't know. I feel like if you don't need a Hot Route, I'd probably go with a guy like Mac or Zach or Joe or Carson. So I know Zach actually does not get the fearless combo. Zach gets Gunslinger, so he's kind of like a cheap, I guess, like a cheap Josh Allen or Joe Kelly. So that's my opinion on the whole Hot Route Master, non-Hot Route Master thing. But let's get into the next quarterback. Okay, so next up we have the flashback Mitchell Trubisky. He's an improviser archetype, so does get, you know, pass lead and dashing. That's probably the best combo I'd run on him unless you want to run escape artist on him. But 86 speed, 88 acceleration, good accuracy stats, actually, like good throw power, 90, 92, 91, good throw on the run. Powered up, does it that throw under pressure threshold, a good play action. He's a pretty good ball carrier too, with a good juke and a decent spin. So Mitch Trubisky also is 6'2", so he's not the tallest either, but actually a pretty solid quarterback, a card I was a fan of. I did a gameplay on this card if you want to see some gameplay on him. But where's Mitch going? We're going to throw Money Mitch Trubisky right in front of Joe Burrow. But I'm going to keep him behind Zach Wilson. I still like Zach Wilson's gunslinger. And also, he still has good speed too, able to roll out and stuff like that. So we're going to leave Zach Wilson just a tick in front of Money Mitch. And honestly, I'm kind of staring at this right now. I'm about to make an adjustment. I usually don't make audibles like this, but I'm about to make a really bold call here. We're going to take this. We're going to do that. I really think Mitch is better than Aaron Rodgers. I do. So I'm going to do that right now. I'm going to throw Mitch in front of Aaron Rodgers. That one might get a little bit of hate, but I'm going to do that. I feel much better about that. Okay, so next up, we have the 95 overall limited time harvest Matt Stafford with 78 speed, 82 acceleration. So pretty decent when it comes to rolling out. Good awareness, does get gunslinger with a 95 throw power. Good accuracy stats, good deep back at 94, 94, 92. So that's really good accuracy stats right there. Throw the run at 88. Could definitely be a little bit better, but good throw under pressure, good play action. And Matt Stafford has a pretty good release too with that gunslinger, and from the pocket having that accuracy. Definitely a really nice card. There's a reason why you see a lot of him. And also, his price was pretty affordable. It is still very affordable. He's still going for quick sell. So Matt Stafford, in my opinion, still a really good purchase. If you are someone that wants to just try throwing from the pocket, and you're not going to lose much. You're not losing much if you sell Matt Stafford a month from now, because you can just hit quick sell and get the coins right back with no tax. So that's definitely a W. So we're going to throw Matt Stafford right up here in front of Josh Allen. And yeah, on to the next one. Next man up is the Blitz Jalen Hurts, and this card, I've seen a couple clips of him. He does look pretty good. He does play pretty well, but the abilities for me is what kind of kill this card. He gets really bad abilities. Even when he's powered up, I'll go to the power just to kind of show you. Even when the card is powered up, he just doesn't get good abilities. Like, he doesn't. He kind of gets the same abilities as Marcus Mariota, but he doesn't get that discount. That's why Marcus is where he's at.
But yeah, Jalen Hurts, 90 speed, 89 acceleration, with 92 throw power, which is pretty nice. Decent accuracy stats, good throw on the run. He's 6'1". So even a good ball carrier too. So we're going to throw Jalen Hurts. We're going to throw him at B tier right behind Jake Plummer. But yeah, I mean, if all these scrambler archetypes or improvisers, whatever, he's actually a scrambler, but if all these scrambling archetypes, they had the same discounts as Mariota, it'd be a really good archetype. But yeah, not everyone gets the same discounts as Marcus Mariota, unfortunately. Okay, so next up we have Blitz Lamar Jackson, who just took a major price drop. So if you did want Lamar Jackson and couldn't afford him, you now can afford him. And we all know why his price did drop that drastically from about 550, 600K to now 200K and dropping as the seconds go by. So if you want Lamar, buy him now. I also would power up Lamar so he's able to hit the mid and deep accuracy thresholds, which is very important. And also Lamar has a really good release too, like a very good release, a very, very, very good release that I love. I probably still would have Lamar on my team if it weren't for Randall Cunningham coming out today. But I mean, good speed, a good dual threat quarterback. I would run pass lead and dashing on Lamar. That's my biggest tip right there. I mean, you could run escape, but I think you not running a pass lead or velocity adding ability does just, it just kills your quarterback's passing ability so much that you kind of have to run it. It is unfortunate, but yes, you have to run either pass lead or set feed or gunslinger or one of those abilities on your quarterback. I think it is a must in a lot of scenarios, in a ton of scenarios. So yeah, Lamar Jackson, a really nice card. I think of this, you know, if I dropped this video a day earlier, he'd probably still be in the same spot, to be honest. He'd probably still be in the same exact spot. But Lamar, a nice card. If you like those dual threat quarterbacks, I think right now he's the best option in the game. So Lamar Jackson going at S tier. And kind of going back to the same point that I made about Tom Brady and Big Ben, all these hot route master guys, the same thing kind of applies to these running quarterbacks. If you don't need a quarterback that has elite running talent, then your tier list might look like this, or maybe even like this. I know people do love Josh Allen in this game, so it might look like that. Maybe even like this if you love Josh Allen that much. But I feel like if you don't need that running aspect, then your tier list could look like this. It's kind of very interesting because there's so much variety at quarterback right now. And maybe not right now because we have Randall, which I'll go over him in a little bit. But yeah, if you need that running aspect, then Lamar's a good option. If you don't, then you might do better with a guy who's a much better passing option against gunslinger and stuff like that. So kind of keep that in mind. So next up, we have the 94 overall Patrick Mahomes, a card that I kind of liked from the pocket. His release with gunslinger was actually pretty solid. I feel like they kind of adjust his release every year, I feel like. And I feel like they've kind of fine-tuned it. I do like his release right now. But this card, he's a big missed opportunity because he has 75 speed with 81 acceleration. So the card doesn't feel like a Mahomes card should. He cannot roll out. You know, he really can't do stuff like that. Does get gunslinger with good accuracy stats, which is definitely nice. Like I said, it's a good release. But at 95, throwing the run does kind of go to waste because he's not able to roll out. Like, I think, what? Doesn't Kirk Cousins literally have better speed? Does Kirk have better speed than Mahomes? He does. Think about that. They gave Kirk Cousins better speed than Mahomes on a lower overall card. That's ridiculous. So hopefully on the next Patrick Mahomes card, we are able to get, you know, the escape artist gunslinger combo, maybe discounted, maybe shout out, maybe EA. Come on, EA. Come through, EA. But yeah, Patrick Mahomes, I think he's a solid card. I'm going to throw him, even from the pocket, I think he's good. Like, he's a good passer. I probably would still go with like guys like Josh Allen and Stafford over him. But again, if you don't need Hot Route Master, it might look like this for you. But I'm going to leave it like this because I value Hot Route Master on Kirk, and I think Kirk cards play very well. But so do Mahomes cards. But Mahomes on this card, they definitely did cheat his speed, and he's kind of missing something. That's the one thing that he's missing, the ability to roll out really nicely. And he can make that throw on the run, but again, it's hard for you to get outside the pocket with this card because he is so sluggish. Okay, so down to our final two cards, and we have the 93 overall legend Jim Kelly with 80 speed, 84 acceleration. Throw on the run, not the greatest, but does get that gunslinger ability with some pretty good accuracy stats as well and a pretty decent release. So 93 short, 90 mid, 92 deep, 93 throw under pressure. Good throw under pressure. No, 93 throw power, 93 throw under pressure, sorry, with a 93 play action. Not a good ball carrier either, but does have decent speed. The card can roll out. I would probably try setting your feet, especially because he's not hitting that 90 threshold. So a lot of inconsistencies when it comes to throwing on the run when you don't have 90. So yeah, Jim Kelly, we're going to throw him. I think he's still S tier just because of that gunslinger and his accuracy stats, but he's definitely fringe. He is definitely fringe. And finally, last but not least, we have the man himself, Randall Cunningham. And this card is just a menace, man. And look at his price. Like, a very, very, very affordable card. So you're going to see a lot of this dude, and he is the best quarterback in the game right now. I know how I kind of talked about, you know, with Lamar and Matt Stafford and Josh Allen. If you want the running aspect, then, you know, you can have Lamar. If not, then you probably have guys like Matt Stafford and Josh Allen over them. But Randall Cunningham, he's a better passer, debatably, than Matthew Stafford and Josh Allen. And he's a better runner than Lamar Jackson as well. So he's that guy, man. He really is that guy. Power him up. And we're talking, look at the accuracy stats. 94 mid, 91 deep, 90 short. Hits it throw on the run threshold, throw under pressure threshold. Play action, I mean, it's not really important, but he does hit that threshold if you need it. 94 throw power with 94 juke, 94 spin, good carrying, and 94 COD with a 94 break tackle, and 94 ball carry vision. If you did miss this gameplay, I dropped it earlier. This card is just nutty, man, and hopefully it's kind of the start to a bunch more glitchy quarterbacks like this. But, I mean, this guy's the best of both worlds. If you do still need Hot Route Master, your tier list might look like this, but mine looks like this. Randall Cunningham, Gunslinger is all you need, and you saw the stats, and the card has a good release. He plays super well. He's 6'4". I mean, what more could you really ask for in a quarterback right now? Like, what more could you really want? All right, guys, so that is going to do it for the updated quarterback tier list. I will probably be updating this tier list again at around, like, Christmas time, probably, like, maybe around, like, New Year's. Maybe that week between Christmas and New Year's, I'll update this because I feel like we're going to get a bunch of spicy content through December. So I'm definitely going to want to kind of update this tier list again real soon. But our top five today is Randall Cunningham at one, Dan Marino at two, Lamar Jackson at three with Matt Stafford and Josh Allen. And I feel like you could switch any of these three guys around. I feel like these two guys could be flipped and flopped if you want Hot Rat or not. But Randall Cunningham is just that guy. But honestly, yeah, these three could all be flipped around. If you like Josh, you can put him there. But like I said at the beginning of the video, it all comes down to preference. What do you like at quarterback? What are you most comfortable with? That's really all that matters at the end of the day. So yeah, if you are still watching, let's comment the demon emoji for a chance to be shouted out in the next video. And if you are new here, hit that subscribe button, turn notifications. We post daily Madden 22 content. And as always, I will see you boys in the next one.